And welcome back to my channel. It's Shantae's Way here today. And today I'm going to be telling you guys about something that I used to do all the time back when I was transitioning. Nonetheless, it's still a great ideal for those of you who like to do this or who are transitioning and need extra benefits or extra things to boost your products because your products are not working as good as they are supposed to, maybe because your hair is not where it's supposed to and isn't taking well with the products, or maybe because you're buying kind of cheap products and you don't want to spend too much money on natural hair products. We're going to talk about that today, what to add to your conditioners. This is regular conditioners and deep conditioners. So the first thing you can add to your deep conditioner or your regular conditioners is oil. That's my favorite thing to add to my deep conditioners. And I used to add like oils to my regular conditioners. I used to add it to my gels, like the Eco Sour gel. I used to add like olive oil into that to make it, I don't know, I thought it was doing something. But yes, oils definitely work well with being like an addition to something, especially like essential oils or cooking oils, whatever you wanna add. So like I said, my favorite was olive oil to add to my gels. I also used to add coconut oil to my conditioners. You can add grapeseed oil. You can add any type of oil that works good with your hair to your conditioner, and it will just boost the results that you get. In my case, I love to add oils to the regular conditioners when I'm detangling my hair, because sometimes conditioners that don't have a lot of slip, if you add an oil to it, it will actually give the conditioner more slip so that it's easier to detangle, and also your hair can come out a lot shinier. Also, some conditioners don't come with all the ingredients that you want it to come with. So like things like vitamin E oil and stuff like that, you can just go ahead and add into the conditioner. Another thing that is a great addition to your conditioner or any other product that you want to add to is aloe vera juice. In gel, aloe vera juice and gel are so good to be like added in your conditioners or in your curl refreshers that you use daily on your hair. I just love aloe vera for pretty much a lot of things. Most of the time for me, I use it for a curl refresher. I add it to my curl refreshers and stuff like that. The only thing with aloe vera juice that can get a little tricky is that you can't just leave it out on the shelf. It does not have a lot of shelf life. So if you're using real aloe vera juice, you're probably going to have to store whatever you add the aloe vera juice or gel to in the refrigerator. But like I said, I personally like to add it to like curl refreshers or something like that. Something that has a lot of moisture in it that is water-based. Most of the time, that's okay to leave in the refrigerator. But as far as conditioners, if you're adding aloe vera juice or gel to your conditioner, then you want to use it all at one time. So this will probably be something that you just add to the amount of conditioner that you're using for that one time, so that you don't have to worry about your conditioner going bad because you left it out on the counter or something like that. If you're wondering, aloe vera juice is good for shine and moisture in the natural hair. Another ingredient that you can add to mostly your deep conditioners, because I add this a lot to my deep conditioners. I've never added to an actual conditioner. But that ingredient is honey. Honey is really good to add to your deep conditioners. Now, I had someone comment on one of my videos and say that they think that I shouldn't use honey in my deep conditioners. I don't use honey all the time, but I personally think that honey works really well with my hair. I've never had any problems out of it. But like I said, I add it to my deep conditioners most of the time. It's not something that I add to like all my products, because honestly, I think that honey is super sticky. So if you're ever adding honey to any product, it needs to be a product that you're actually washing out. So you can play around with different ingredients and see what works for you. If it doesn't work for you, then throw it out, don't do it anymore. But at least you tried it out, and at least you gave it a go so that you can see if it works with your hair. I know you guys didn't think I was doing a video without saying Jamaican Black Castor Oil. You guys know that I love Jamaican Black Castor Oil. That's a good one to add to your conditioner. Also, that's just Jamaican Black Castor Oil. You don't actually have to add it to anything. Just add it to your regimen and you will see major, major results. So Jamaican Black Castor Oil, or some people always ask me like if I use regular castor oil. No, actually I don't. I've never bought the actual like regular castor oil. I always get Jamaican Black Castor Oil. And like I've mentioned many times on my channel, Jamaican Black Castor Oil is good for hair growth. And that's the reason why I started using it so long ago. And that's the reason why I continue to use it, because it really does help with hair growth and just overall hair health. Now, I haven't tried this, but I have seen some naturals do it. And that's the green tea rinse. The tea rinse, or a green tea rinse, or a black tea rinse, or whatever rinse you want to do, is supposed to be really good for your hair, especially when it has to do with like hair shedding, hair growth, hair shine. That's supposed to be like the go-to rinse to keep your hair all intact and reduce hair shedding, help hair growth, help hair shine. But like I said, I personally haven't tried it, but I've seen it work for many naturals, and I also know some naturals that have tried that out. Now, with adding tea to your conditioners, what you would do is put the tea rinse on your hair and then put the conditioner over the tea rinse. And like I said, that would probably be a really good addition to the conditioner, especially with slip, especially with hair shedding, especially with hair growth, those type of things. Yeah, so that about wraps up the things that I feel are really good to add to conditioners. Like I said, you want to play around with a lot of ingredients, because you don't want to just not try things out just because you feel like, or you heard someone say that they don't work or something like that. You have to literally get in and do trial and error with your natural hair. You don't get the most out of your hair journey when you don't do trial and error, because that's how I've learned. Trial and error, just doing things and just going for it and seeing what works on my hair. And once you find the things that work for your hair, try to stick to them. Don't you know, find a bunch of things that work for your hair and then go away from them, because that's where a lot of people mess up. Switch it up, but don't, you know, stray away from the things that you know your hair love. And down in the comments, let me know what you guys add to your deep conditioners or your conditioners. Is there some things that you add to your conditioners that I did not mention? And yeah, I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.